Hi everyone, it's Marcie Besecker here on YouTube Live. It's Tuesday at 2 o'clock. I am an independence demonstrator for Stampin Up. Thank you so much for joining me today. So we have so much to talk about today. Let me see. Skip ads. See comments. That's what I want. Yay! So I've been super busy this week. I've been recording videos for you guys, so I'm excited about that. I did rewatch one of them yesterday when I was loading it and making sure everything's right. And I noticed that when I'm talking to you, I look at my camera, at my screen on my computer. But when you're not here, I tend to look at the camera thinking I need to look at the camera. Well, I use an external camera because the one on my laptop is just terrible. And so it's weird. When I look straight at my screen, it looks like I'm looking at you. But when I look at my camera like this, it looks like I'm looking up, which you would think when you're taking a picture, you look at the camera. But anyway, for it to be external, I think that's kind of funny. So one of my videos that I do, and maybe both, I don't know, I'm kind of looking up. But when I'm talking to you, I think I look at the monitor because I want to make sure I'm in frame and you can see me and all that good stuff. So, all right. So anyway, there's that. Let's see. Hi, Bonnie. Nola, how are you? So I have a few announcements to make today and I'm super excited about it. Hi, Tilly. Welcome. So let's get started on the announcements really quick. So let's see. So I told you about the videos. I had to tell you because it's going to look kind of weird that I'm looking up, but that's why. I don't know why when I'm not talking to you, you're not here. I think I need to look up. Weird. Hi, Terry. Welcome. Your package is in the mail, so you should be getting it soon. And congratulations again. The paper share. This is going to be the last couple days. I have been having some trickle in to add to our good group of people doing our paper share. I can't even tell you how amazing this paper is. And again, if you are interested in just getting a little bit of all of it to give it a try, see what you like the best, $55 only, and that includes the shipping. So please sign up before the 3rd. I am putting my order in the night of the 3rd, like 12:01 my time. 11:01 my time, because that would be midnight and I can put my order in. So don't forget that. Oh, you're welcome, Terry. So if you're here, especially if you're new, say hi. I'd like to welcome you. I always like to know who's watching. It's funny, I get a lot of comments from people after the fact, and I'm like, oh, you should have said hi. I would have known you were there. So say hi. I'd love to know that you are here. All right, so let me check off my list. I happen to have my marker here, which I normally don't write with, but I'm just going to do a little check mark, make sure I have my info I'm sharing. Hi, Linda. Welcome. I'm glad you guys put where you're from because I don't always remember. Hi, Barbara. Hi, Felicia. So I love to know where you guys are from. That's fun because I don't know why. Sometimes I think someone's close and then they're far. Oh, Bonnie, I'm glad you did. You're going to love it. Love it, love it. All right, so paper share. So if you're interested in the paper share, over on my blog, on the top there, it says events and classes. That is where you're going to go. Fill out the form and your email. I'm going to invoice you through PayPal because I don't have my blog set up for payment quite yet. But I'm not sure I'm going to do it. I don't do a lot other than kind of a couple classes and the paper share. So, but I'll just invoice you through PayPal and then that way I can get your address from there, create a label and get that right out to you. Oh, Tilly, Blackpool in the UK, welcome. Carolyn, welcome. I'm glad you made it. Hi, Susan. Belinda, welcome. Michelle and Jennifer. So, okay, so that is the paper share. So you still have time to jump on that, fill out the information. So really $47 other than shipping for 148 6x6 pieces of paper. That's going to include the fun sparkle paper the shimmer paper and the new in color DSP along with all the 12 by 12 new DSPs. All right. Okay, so that is paper share. Okay, so two more things. On the YouTube channel, I've had quite a few people ask me about, but they're not getting notifications. So let me jump on and show you here. When you hit the subscribe button, a little bell will show up. When you click on the bell, it's going to be none, which means you just want my channel listed to the left of your YouTube that you can just scroll down the channels and watch your normal people that you like to watch. So that you would just subscribe and that would be it. Personalized, I'm not really sure what that is, to be totally honest with you, but I know if you select all, then all is you will get the video, you'll get notification, you'll get an email, everything that you're connected to there, you will get notifications that I am that I have recorded alive. So just make sure, even though you subscribe, you must hit the bell and then just select all. And then you'll get notified if I posted, like I'm going to be in the next week because I'm not going to be live. Or if I do post live, then you will get notifications of that. So keep that in mind. Really? Oh, Terry, it does say that you have to have your YouTube on. So let me show you this. Right here it says subscribers who turned on all notifications for your channel. So this is just an idea of the percentage. And then subscribers who turn on all notifications for your channel and enable the YouTube notifications. And read right here. Oh, it's not right there. There was another place that said you must have your YouTube open. So I'm guessing, I always have my YouTube open, so I get notifications. But either in the background, have it open, on your phone, have it open, wherever you need to. Have it open so it will pop up. Hi, Tashana. So try that. Just make sure you have YouTube open in the background. And like I use Chrome, so one of my tabs is always YouTube. It's always open. And that way, that's how I, you know, am able to respond quickly. If I'm on my computer or if I am on my phone, I try to have YouTube open if I'm not by my computer. But that way I also get my notifications that somebody's popped up. All right. Another thing that I want to share with you is I have changed my code already to May because I am leaving town and I want my May code to be available and everybody to be ready to do your purchasing for the new catalog. So that is the new code on my blog on the right side, right below my shop button where it says host code. That is also now updated with May. It says April there because this is an old picture, but that is, it's also there. And if you go to my Facebook business page, Marcie Besecker Designs, it is the top pinned post you're going to see, and that is my code. So, okay, Terry, great. Right, Nola. So yeah, you have to be into your YouTube account is connected to your Google account, right? So when you're signed in, you need to be signed in, like Nola said, to your Google and your YouTube there to make sure that you're signed into YouTube with your Google account so you can get notifications. Also, if you have told Google, do not notify me, not on YouTube, but on Google, then you're not going to get notified because that's how they notify you through that. So there's a little bit of a learning curve there, so take a look. Make sure your all of your notifications are turned on for those Google and YouTube. Okay, so my host code, joining the team starting May 4th is an amazing deal right now. Instead of $125, you're going to get $155 in product for only $99. Sorry, got to take a drink there. If you have been considering it and you've been thinking about it, you're not sure, you don't think you're going to make the quota, that's what I hear the most. I don't think I'm going to make the quota. It is easier than you think. You have 3 months to make the $300. And May, January, March, April, May. May is in the middle of a quarter. So you have January, February, March, April, May, and June. Because you're in the middle of a quarter, you're going to get through the end of June and then all the way through the end of September. So end of September, you need $300. Then October is a grace period. So if you're like 275, 250, you're not quite sure you can make that 300, they do give you a grace period. But remember, that's also part of your next quarter. So it's easier than you think. It's a perfect time to give it a try right now. Get a discount on all the new goodies in the catalog and see what happens. Especially right now with the new catalog, you may make your quota without a problem. Then the holiday catalog comes. Share your information with your friends. Create a host code. Share, share, share. And you'll get orders. I had a downline that didn't think she could do it. She was new. I said, you've got to share it. So she shared it and said, I'm trying to have a party, blah, blah, blah. Made her quota, no problem. People will help you. So put it out there and let them know. The other thing I want to let you know is if you are not a demonstrator and you're interested in having a party, you let me know. We'll set up a party for you. I'll give you a host code and do a virtual party. Share that code with everybody. Let them know you're having a party. You want to earn some free stuff. And you can use your credit and have yourself a party and earn some free things. And then you can also use that credit to go towards a kit if you decide to do that. So there's all kinds of things you can do to earn free stuff. Let me know if you would like to, either as a customer holding a party or a demonstrator. Okay, that's a lot of business stuff. One last thing that I know you're not going to want to miss. And where's my flyer? Here we go. Starting May 4th, here is another amazing reason to have yourself a party. If you have a party, the third column there, additional Stampin' rewards, you are going to get not only your 10 to 16%, depending on the size of your party, you are also going to get an additional $25 in Stampin' rewards at the 250 level or above. Okay, so if you hit $250 or more, you're going to get an additional bonus of $25. So that's not for each level. You want to read from the left to the right, not top to bottom. So you're not going to get $25 for, you know, $250. And then when you hit 300 and when you hit 450, that's not how it works. Read from the left to the right. And then once you hit 450 or more, you also get a 50% off item. So really the bonus of this right now is that extra $25. So there's another reason to earn some free stuff and have a party. So if you'd like to have one, let me know and we'll get you set up. And you can throw that code out there to all your friends and let them know that you're doing a party and see what happens. All right, so let's get busy now. I think that is all the announcements. Of course, there is the, oh, one last thing. All right, so somebody had asked, I believe it was Barbara, had asked about my punch holder. So the bottom one is the one that I had, and then I moved all my punches up that are retired. Oh, and I have not added my new ones on there yet. So my new, the first column, I have a lot on there from the new ones. So hi, Samantha. Welcome. So that is the punch holder that I have, which is the largest one. And I keep all my punches. I love, love, love all my punches. So I can't believe they got rid of like the circles, the squares, the ovals, all those. I know we have dies, but for me, especially if I'm doing a lot of stuff, I like to just punch, punch, punch and be done with it. But it is what it is. And now we have some new stuff. So hello, Melinda. All right, let's get started today. We are going to create this really cute card. I have been doing so much with the pale papaya and the polished pink that I really wanted to do something with the fresh freesia. I think it's so, so pretty. I also really like this elegantly said. Now, a lot of people are like, oh, I looked at it. I don't know. The paper is a little, let me grab the paper so I can show you. The paper is a little bold. I know it's up here, I just have to find it. I just got it, I didn't cut it down yet or anything, I don't think. Okay, so I only have one package, so I didn't love it, chop it, but I have this paper, and this goes with the sweet. Okay, so there's just all of this, like, I think this would make a great masculine card. It looks like the same kind of print in our in-color DSP. And so this is kind of a bold paper set, and I know a lot of people are like, oh, I don't know, like, I love this. It's the vanilla, and the gray is really pretty. But it's really bold, I know. And so some people are like, oh, I don't know. But you can change it up and turn it into something like this. I really love the flower. I'm going to show you a couple tips and tricks of what I did with this. As soon as my chair cooperates. Thanks, guys. I'm glad you like it. And so here we are on the inside, of course. Do a little decorating there. So I'm going to show you some things I changed. Now, with this set, you do not get dies, but you get the punch, okay? So we're going to set that aside. And so it just kind of, I just really like how it popped. I love the background. And so we're going to get busy and get started, and I can show you what we did. Also, of course, I used the Hippo and Friends. Now, I'm going to tell you, this is one other thing I didn't want to forget. Thank goodness I remembered. So today's video and the next two videos while I am on vacation will not have links on the bottom. Well, I take that back. Today's will not have link on the bottom. Well, the other two probably won't either, but they will be on my blog. So as soon as those links are available for me to create, which will be on the 4th, I'm going to create them and add them on my blog. The blog post will already be posted the same day the video is shown, but there's probably not going to be any supplies for a little while because we can't get those links until then. Once I create them, I'll add them on there for you if you need to know exactly what everything is. Okay, all right, back to the project. Hi, Jody. Oh, Tilly, I know I like the paper a lot, and I've used it for some other stuff too. So I used the two largest for this here, and then I used the punch, and I made some adjustments to the punch. So I'll show you that also. So let's just get busy. So here are my pieces. Here's my rhinestones. This tells you how many packs of rhinestones I have. What is different about this package? Can you guys tell that there's something different about this package? Let me know if you know what it is. Just curious if you know. I noticed it right off. All right, so we have our fresh freesia ribbon. So I'm going to set that aside. I went ahead and cut this because you guys know how to die cut, right? I'm just, the other ones are going to have a little bit of a story to it. Now this I cut from one of our green panels. Yes, Jennifer and Arlene, old packaging, correct. When I left the first time, I took glue dots, rhinestones, and our Tombow glue. I had that credit that we had, you know, Stampin' Reward money or whatever, and I bought a ton of them, and I took them with me. And so I still have a ton, and I've been crafting for years, so that tells you I bought a lot of them. So this came off the side, you know, of the paper when I was doing my cutting. So I kept this because I'm going to add it on the inside, but we're not going to do it right now. We're going to go ahead and set this aside and bring our Stamparatus in. So on this one, what I did, oops, where am I? I did the lace right here. So I'm going to use the lace. I'm going to use our flower, and I'm going to use our wishing you a wonderful birthday. Okay, so that's what we're going to use. Oh, I am going to use this also. This really pretty, a lacy I don't know what you call it, but emblem or whatever. So we're going to go ahead and set this aside. I did put the flowers and the sentiment on there, so we're going to set that aside. We're going to take our paper, and this is cut at 3 1/4 by 5 because I'm going to be layering this up on top of our Parapizazz. So I'm using Parapizazz. Okay. So I went ahead and moved it in a little bit because I don't want it way in the corner, especially when it's such a long stamp. I'm going to take this and put that there. I'm going to move this one out of the way. All right, so let's start. Here we are with our Parapizazz and Fresh Freesia. And we started with Fresh Freesia. And not for any particular reason. In fact, I may have thought about changing it up, but because there's green all the way around, I just decided to do this one. So we're going to just ink that up and go across. Okay, now I'm going to take it out and I'm going to move it down 2. 1, 2. All right, so now I'm going to ink it up again. Make sure your paper's straight, and it is, and just go across one time. All right, now I'm going to keep my paper still with a finger and move my magnet up there. All right. Now we're going to go down 2 again, 1, 2. We're going to ink it up. And just go across. It's such a pretty stamp. All right, now we're going to take this off. Because it is still on here, I'm just going to use a baby wipe. I don't want to take the stamp off. And we're just going to take the Fresh Freesia off. I don't like to rub it too hard. I don't want to take it off of the platform. But then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a towel or tissue or whatever you have. And I just like to wet it just to make sure that it's not wet. All right, now we're going to go back up into the second position because we don't want to go over the purple. All right. And now we're going to take our Parapizazz. And we're going to go straight across. And this is just kind of filling in the background a little bit just to add. Now, I don't want to put this right on the green because I just stamped it. I'm just going to move it up a little bit. And now, again, we're going to move down 2. And, of course, I have my case, stamp case under here. I always want a stamp case or an ink pad because it just makes this nice and level. So it's easier to stamp on. All right, so we're going to take this and I'm just going to clean that off for now. So here is our background. Isn't that pretty? Nice and simple. So we'll just set that aside. And now I'm going to take in a white piece of paper. And I put this behind. See how it went over the outside? And so I'm just going to add this. This is a scrap piece of paper that I just have that I'm going to use. I'm going to move this back up just to get it out of the way. And now we're going to bring in our flower and our sentiment. All right, we're going to move this over here now. So now I have a flat surface at the top. I'll move it down a little bit. Hi, Darlene. Welcome. All right, so I'm trying to move it down a little. Here, let me move it out a little. See if that helps. There we go. All right, so we're going to do our Parapizazz here. We're going to do the green, and we're going to do the whole image and the sentiment. All right, we're going to just move our magnet. All All right, and I think that is good enough. So I'm just gonna wipe that off so I can set aside and not get something green. We are actually not setting it aside. So let's move this off for a second and grab another piece of paper, which I forgot about. I'm gonna make sure I have the green off. And you can just do this with your hand too. It's just taking that extra bit of water off. And now we're gonna do it in purple. We're gonna do our fresh freesia. Let me go ahead and just put my magnet on here so it doesn't go anywhere. And my washi is starting to tear. All right, so we'll put that there. And now we just need the flower. Okay, I got a little on a sentiment, but that's okay. I just want the flower. And I'm going to do it one more time because I want it a little bolder. Hi, Cindy. Okay, that's what I want. Nice and bold. Hi, Susan. Welcome. No problem. We did a lot of announcements. There's some really good announcements at the beginning, so make sure you catch those. Some specials and things going on. All right, so now I'm going to just put my magnets back in here so I don't lose those. I took the foam part off, of course, because these are red rubber. I'm just going to leave that on and move that away. Okay, so now a little bit of magic. We are going to take this and we are going to die cut it with the second, hi Rosemary, the second, I'm not even sure what shape this is, kind of circle shape, not these, but this one. So this one is going to be on the white and this one is going to be on the purple, which I already did. Okay, so through magic, ta-da, that is die cut. So there is that piece. Okay. Now, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and take our sentiment and punch it. And then we're going to do a little bit of a change up on it. So what I like to do is this one is a little long. When I was making sure that my flower and my sentiment aligned up, I used the center. I used this panel on accident. And then I realized I had to go back and cut another piece, and now it's a little bit long. All right, so we're just going to make sure that this little curved spot misses that W. All right, so just kind of get that in there. And right about there is fine for me. All right, and then what I did is because the card right here, I didn't want to cut to cover this big spot up right here. I really wanted this to be our main focus. And so instead of layering that there, I trimmed this down. If you can see it, it's a little bit of a different shape than what the punch is. All right. So what I did is I took my trimmer, and you can use whichever one you want. And all I did is I went in, tried to go to an even line, and I just cut. See how that is? And then I went over here, same kind of thing, went to an even line right here, so it's 1 1/4, and I cut. Okay, so that's kind of how you can come out and make it just a little bit longer, as 1 1/4 off of each is what I cut. I'm going to bring this in to keep my mat a little bit clean here. But then what I'm going to do is I came in with this pretty stamp right here. This one. Yeah, Terry, I like it because I really like the punch. But for some things, because this center piece is so big, I didn't want such a big stamp. Now, I want to put some little bit of design behind it. Let me move this back in. I know you can't see, it's kind of up high. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to stamp this in the Fresh Freesia just to kind of tie the color in. And I'm going to stamp 3 times off because I just want a super light image. And it does not have to be, that's even a little lighter than this one. And I am okay with it. You can, in person, you can definitely see it. So I don't know if you're going to be able to see it on here, but it's definitely on there. So that's perfect for me because I thought this was a little too dark. So I'm happy that I kind of pushed it, I think, and took that little extra off. Hi, Karma. Welcome. All right. So there's our sentiment. Here's our pieces here. Now what are we going to do? We are going to take our purple image and we're going to fussy cut. Eek, fussy cut. It does not take that long. I'm going to leave a little bit of white around, not a lot, because it's a white background, so I just want my edges a little smooth. Nothing crazy, because like I said, the background's white. And we're just going to, remember, just keep turning your paper and let it do all your work for you. Now, I went ahead and left that. That looks like a leaf to me. You can tell right there that it's a leaf. On here, it's kind of hard because it's purple and you're like, okay, wait, is that like a little bud? No, it's a leaf. So I'm going to cut around that and then go to the small flower. You know, I didn't cut them out separate. They're close enough. They've got the perfect spacing around them. I kind of like to cut with the paper. I mean, with the image, so if it has like a little indention or whatever, just kind of go with it. It just makes it look a little more realistic. It just gives it a little more, I don't know. And like right there, I got a little close, not so much white, but it's okay. Like I said, it's a white background, so you're not really going to be able to tell. All right, go all the way up because those are going to be green on the other one. And now at this point, when your scissors are getting stuck in there, I like to just cut that off so it's a little easier for you to get in there and do what you need to do. All right, so just keep going. And so like there, I just do like a little squiggle. And you could have left this little thing here purple if you wanted, but I didn't want to. I liked how the green is like, you know, the triangle. It's just kind of has a little bit of green everywhere. It could be little, looks like little lilac pieces or something. All right, and then I'm going to go back there. There we go. So there's our purple. And now you're going to take this here, and I'm going to add a little bit of liquid. Thank you so much, everybody, for commenting on my last video. I really appreciate it. Like I said, that's what really brings your YouTube kind of to the top, and you know, when people are watching and YouTube says, oh, people are watching, okay, and it just really helps my channel. So anybody that you watch, you know, make sure that you like and comment, and even if it's just saying hi from wherever, or you know, enjoyed the video, or catching on replay, whatever you say, it helps. All right, so there you go, look at that. You can't even tell. So pretty. So, here we go, let's add this on here. We're gonna use some ribbon, we're gonna use I'm just gonna go ahead and use liquid. I like to use liquid on stuff like this when I'm layering, just because I like to move it around a little bit. Kind of get an idea of where your center is. All right, so that looks good to me. And so just set that aside and let that sit there. All right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to take our panels. Oh, you know what I forgot? Duh. Okay, let's do that real quick. This goes on that. That goes with that. The inside. So what I did is I took the inside. I'm going to bring back in the Stamparatus. I'm putting green in the background, and I have that little green strip of paper that I showed you. So let's move this. Let's put that there. And we are going to bring our inside piece inside, and we are going to lay it this way. Okay, make sure you've got your stamp. So we're going to have to go down a little farther. It does, ooh, let me think. I think I did it the other way. Let me see. I did do it the other way. So I think I took it off. Let's turn this over. I want this. Now, I'm not going to put my paper there because I don't want it to accidentally still have a little ink on it and then get my paper. So I'm going to lay it down there because I wanted it to go on the outside because I want the green strip to go along right there. So if you're making a bunch of these at one time, then make sure you do all of your outside panels first before you turn it around to do your inside. Okay, so that will help you. All right, so now I'm just going to move it down, and it does not have to be hanging over the edge, but I kind of want to make sure it's kind of edge to edge. All right, so let's put our magnet on there, and we are going to make this purple. All right, so here we go. Let me move this up for you a little bit. Stay in camera, Marcie. Okay, so we're going to do purple. So our fresh freesia. I know I'll start saying fresh freesia. For now, I say purple. I love all the new colors. Oh, thanks, Jennifer. Yeah, I really love all the new colors. You know which one's my favorite? It's the one I'm using. That's always my favorite. Not necessarily this one. Whichever color I'm using, that's the one that's my favorite. All right, so a sneak peek really quick on one of the videos when I'm gone. Ready? All right, that's all you get. That's it. And I change them up. I do several different kinds. And I think you're really going to like it. It shows a lot of different things you could do to make your card look a little different. Okay, see how there's a little bit on each edge? And that is absolutely fine. So let's move this back over here. All right. So now here we have this. Let's pull in our silicone mat. All right. I'm trying to keep this a little bit clean so it doesn't look so crazy when I move this away and you guys are looking at it, because it can get messy. And then I use it for the rest of the week, although the rest of my week is very short. Okay, so right here, I don't know why I'm turning it sideways. I can see the lines. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to line this right on the top of a dark line right there, right? Now I'm going to take this, and I'm just going to put it right. So I'm using this line here and this line over here, and I can see it through my silicone mat. All right, so don't forget about your silicone mat as a ruler. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put my little bit of adhesive, not a lot. We're just tying in the colors from the outside to the inside. And now I want it to go right along the stamped image, but also right along this line right here. And that just shows you that because you stamped it with your Stamparatus, it's going to be nice and straight. And now see what I just did? I had a tiny bit of white right there showing, so I just rolled my hand, not too hard, but because it's liquid, I was able to just slide it just slightly down so you don't see that white. I too, too. I love the end colors. Love, 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 love. If you are joining me late, don't forget to watch the beginning because I had a lot of announcements, some new specials coming up. Now, I'm going to take my piercing tool. You guys know that when I see a little bit of glue, I just roll it right like that, and it comes right off. All right. Now, we're going to put this on the inside, which means it's going to go right on top of our green. All right, so this is going to go here. I want to make sure. Yep, that's 4. Now, I've replaced, I don't know how many of these seals, because I keep running out of them. All right. There we go. All right. I had to take my poor doggie to the vet yesterday. He has an ear infection in both ears. He's been shaking like crazy. He's a little multi-poo. And his little ears, he stopped. And after we got him groomed, and we were like, oh, he just had hair in his ear. So he's good. And he was good for like 5 days, and then he started shaking again. And I was like, oh. And apparently the doctor said that that breed is very well known for a lot of hair in their ears. And so they hold whatever can get in their ear. So little leaves or stickers or foxtails or whatever, which we have none of that in our backyard, but whatever it was. All right. So now we have our two panels, and we're going to add our ribbon. He's fine. He's eating. He's drinking. He took his medicine like a champ, except we're going out of town and have some friends watching them, so I'm hoping that they don't forget to give him this medicine. It's an older couple. They just love him. They call him their grandson. Okay, I have a little too much ribbon here that I feel like I'm wasting, but gotta do what you gotta do, right? Oh, thanks, Jennifer. Yeah, I just think it finishes. I like to do the envelope too. I don't always do the envelope. It depends. Sometimes I just don't have time if I'm wanting to get something out. And I don't want to waste my DSP by putting it on ahead of time. And then when I decide that I need the card, it's when my husband's like, oh, it's so-and-so's birthday. We got to get it in the mail. Their birthday's tomorrow. And I'm like, you know, they're not going to get it tomorrow, right? But I don't want to put it on the envelopes ahead of time and then that card not go out or, you know, whatever right away. And then I need that paper. Okay, I'm going to adjust this once we get everything on and make this a little shorter. Now, remember, this is not glued down, so you can just kind of move it over to wherever you want it. Or fold this up a little bit and move it up or down. That's the best way to do it. All right, so you can just kind of do that. All right, but I think first we're going to go ahead and add our panel on. So this is all nicely glued. Now see, I can't pick it up, so I use my little pokey tool to just slide it under and pick it up. All right, so we're going to add our dimensions on this and on here. Except I think I'm getting close to running out of dimensions. So we're just going to use what we got. I mean, I have a whole drawer full, but I have to go get them. So we are just going to use our corners. I think I did that on the videos too. I'm like, I'm going to use these up. They're taking up space on my desk. Don't you hate autocorrect? Sometimes I send it. My poor upline, she's just laughs. And my downline too. They're both like, yeah, we know what you meant. And I'm just like, I am not correcting it. You guys know. You know what I meant. Alright, I'm gonna put one in the middle just because it is a kind of a bigger piece and I don't want it to sink. Oh, Tashana, I purchased one of every color, and I'm so sad that that's all we were able to get. So on the 4th, the 3rd at 11:01, I will be putting my order in with my paper share and getting all my goodies. I have some pre-orders to put in. It's going to be a busy night. I'm not going to be home. I'm taking my laptop. I have all my stuff. I am going to take some crafting. I have a project I'm in the middle of. Two projects, so I'll be working on that. All right, so that looks good. So before we adhere that, let's take this. And we're just going to kind of snuggle it up here. You want your image in the middle, so let's just move this guy over. Remember, this is still hanging off of this card and that card, so you can put this all the way to the left, which is what we're going to do. Like, it's going to be barely on the left right there, because I want this to be in the middle. Okay, so you can kind of now see that this can be nicely proportioned. You want to move it down just a little bit, because you've got this big white spot here and up there, and I didn't do that on this one. And then I realized, well, we're putting that there too, but I just wanted to bring it down a little bit just so you can see that lace. So let's go ahead and put this on. Thank you, Eileen. You know what? I know you guys know what, if you guys have been watching me for a while, what am I really anxious to get? I mean, not the stamp set, but an embellishment. What am I, like, really can't wait to get? I am so anxious for that. All right, so we're going to go just right about there. And I like that. I like my ribbon where it's at. So now let's add our adhesive on here. Because it's kind of heavy on the top, I'm going to add a little in the middle. And I like to add some on the ribbon, if you can get it there. And it's not taking it because of all the bumps on the other side. So I'm just going to add a little bit of liquid just to keep it in the, I don't know why. It's not like it's going to go anywhere, but I like to just make sure that it's secure. All right. And you know, I like to do the panels before I put them on the card. I don't know why. This is the important part. If I mess up the panel, I'll just get another panel. But this is the part that I really want to play with. Okay, so I want my loops kind of small, not super small. All right, I'm going to cut these again. I especially like, I mean, I like embellishments. I'm not a big ribbon person, but I do use a lot of like organza ribbon or the thin, like the white crinkle ribbon, stuff like that I love. All right, now we are going to add, I'm going to add this, but because we are really layered up, I'm also going to add liquid. And I do not remember who I saw that did this. Maybe somebody can remind me. But they did liquid on the inside, like this. And they said it helps them still be able to move it, but you still have your seal on there. And so I don't remember who it was, but they said then put it down. And before you really push it, see how it still has like wiggle. And that's down on the card. So I thought that was really a good idea. All right, so now we have that. Now, this is really pretty, but we're going to really finish it off. I love the organza, Linda. Tashana, my most thing that I'm excited about, well, not, I shouldn't say most thing because I don't have everything yet, but of what we were able to get, are these. Look, there's, I don't want to use, I would love to use the purples on here, but I don't want to use my last few. I love them. They're so pretty. All right, so we're just going to angle this. I was kind of, you know, trying to figure out where to put it, how to do it. And then I thought, you know what? I'm just going to put it right towards the bottom here, just kind of angled. And I thought that that was just so pretty. And now, and you can cut your ribbon shorter or however you want it. I think I want this just a little more outward. So I'm going to pull it this way. See how I pulled it outward and I tightened it up? And now it's a little more out. And so now I'm just going to pull it in a little bit. And I think I'm good with that. I want it a little shorter. I don't want my ribbon to be my main focus. I want this to be. And now we know it looks like it's missing something still. Oh, me too, Tashana. Okay, so now I'm like, something's missing. I need to finish it off. What about Wink Estella? No, didn't want to do that. I liked the look and everything. And then I was like, okay, watch this, you guys. I used the large ones. Look at that. It just really, and then I used a medium one. Boom, bada, boom. And then I went to the small ones. And I just added three of those. This one, oh, it looks kind of weird. Oh, no, I guess not. And then I put it over here. So we're kind of filling up these spaces. And there you go. So there is our card. We layered up the flowers. I mean, this is really a simple card. It looks like a lot. It's really not. You're just layering those up. And for a card to do multiple of, super simple. It's a lot of the Stamparatus does the work. Layer up your image. What I would do is stamp them all out. Your colored ones, just be watching TV at night. Cut out your flowers, and then they're ready to go the next day. And so there are our cards. Yay! So I hope you guys like them. Let me zoom in just a little so you can see them a little bit better. There we go. So you can see the one on the left, this one, the sentiment stamp is a little darker. And then this one's a little lighter, but it is definitely there and so pretty. And I like the lighter one better because I really want the flowers to be the main focus. I love the background, and you cannot find another platform that does this. It's amazing. So a lot of people, when they ask, oh, what's the difference? And why do you like this one more than that one? This is one of the very good reasons that I like it. I mean, there's a lot of good reasons. I love to just put this behind it, and it's nice and flat, easy to stamp, easy to use. I like that it has the two platform lids. I mean, there's so many reasons I like it. I like that it's open-ended, so you can slide your card around and put your picture wherever you want it. There's just a lot of reasons. So there are the cards. And at the beginning, I did do a lot of announcements, so don't forget to go back and check those out. There are some specials going on with Stampin Up you don't want to miss out on. And if you want to get some free product, let me know. You do not have to be a demonstrator, and I can help you out. We can get you some free stuff. You are welcome, you guys. Thank you. All right, so I've already changed my May code. It is now May for me because I'm going on vacation. I wanted to make sure that code was out there for you guys. So it's going to be in my descriptions of my videos. It's going to be on my blog. Always on the top of my blog on the right-hand side, right below shop. Just copy it and go into the shop and you'll have it right there. Oh, good, Felicia. My paper share is going to be over on the 3rd. You have until the 3rd. I'm going to be away, but I am putting in my order and getting it expedited and getting that ready. Look, I already have some of the labels all made to go on your packages. and get those to you so you'll know what they are and what you're going to be getting in that package and the name of it and the number and everything. So it's a perfect way to give the paper a try and make sure that's what you like. Thanks, you guys. I'm going to go see my grandson. I'm so excited. I told my son, they got a new puppy. It's a golden doodle. And I said, the golden doodle was not in the agreement of potty training. My grandson's too. I said, that I can handle, but a golden, so my husband's going with me. I said, you are in charge of the golden doodle. Thanks, you guys. I heard it's going to be rainy up there, so the park might be out, but, you know, ice cream's always in. We'll have fun for sure. We're going to be there for a week. My son's going to go meet an army buddy of his when they were in Afghanistan together. They haven't seen each other in, I think he said, 6 years. So they are going to meet up and have a good time with their wives. They're all friends. So I'm excited about that for them. It's going to be a lot of fun. And then, so we're babysitting. And then when my son comes home, the day he comes home, it is his birthday. So we're going to go out to dinner and enjoy ourselves. We are now vaccinated, so we can go inside. I think Washington is open partially anyway. So we're going to have a good dinner. I'm excited. Oh, you know what? He also has a mini schnauzer. My gosh, the two best dogs ever. Sorry to my Charlie. I had a schnauzer and I loved it, but... Oh, I will, Samantha. Thank you. My son is now out. He's in corrections, though, but his friend is still in, which is why it's hard for both of them to get together because they both have crazy jobs. So, I'm excited about that. It's a funny story, just so you know. I really returned back to stamping when my son was in Afghanistan. Stamping kept me sane because I made scrapbooks for him. I did card making for the military for Operation Right Home. And so that's when I really jumped back into stamping after raising my kids. And that just really, if I didn't have stamping or my husband, because we were dating at the time, but I would have gone nuts. Oh, I love mini schnauzers. They're the best. We've had two. So anyway, so that's that. So lots of announcements. Don't forget at the beginning, Barbara, if you are watching or watching on the replay, here is the punch holder I was telling you about that you asked. You didn't get to, I didn't have the picture up last time. I had my ribbon holder picture last time. And yes, I ordered another one and I moved my retired ones up. And my current ones are below and my new ones, I took this picture before I put my new ones up. So I did get another one. Funny story again. I was going to sell my other one. I said, you know what? I'll just sell it and buy the larger one. Then I realized that was the larger one and that I was in trouble because I needed another large one for my punches. So it's a funny way that you think you have the smaller one and then you don't. All right. I'm going to let you guys go. I want to sit here and visit all day because I am leaving for a week. But I will see you back on Mother's Day. I'll be here on Mother's Day. So I know there's some of you that may already have celebrated or do not have a celebration going on. Bye you later, Tashana. So I hope you join me. And if not, you guys can see the rerun. It will be something new. I don't know what. I do know what. It's going to be Expressions of Ink is what I'm thinking because I'm dying to play with that set or that suite. So I hope you guys join me. Thank you, everybody. Have a great rest of your week, and I will see you soon. Don't forget to watch the replay. Leave a comment. Let me know you're there. I'll probably watch with you. Hopefully, it's during nap time. We'll see. And I'll say hi. All right, everybody. Bye. Thank you.